You better learn how to love.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Come on.
Learn how to love.
Come on,
come on.
This song here is called "Hey Sinner." I'm excited. I'm nervous though, because you know it's brand new. And I hope y'all remember all the lyrics. Amen. Okay. Thank you. You said, "Bless the Lord."
Bless
him. And come on, give me a hug.
Bless him, Lord. Bless him, Lord.
Get your hands up. Bless him, Lord.
Come on, with last. Come on.
Here we go.
Take your hug. Come on.
Two more, and that's it.
Glory.
Bless him.
This next song here is called It's Not Over. Amen.
Come on.
All right.
I don't care what it looks like.
Amen.
I don't care how bad it gets. It's not over until he comes.
Amen.
Amen.
It's not over until my king comes.
Amen.
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 Not over.
Now, here we go.
Glory.
Come on, brother.
Bless him, Lord.
But I know that God has forgiven me.
Amen.
Amen. Come on with it.
But man, I had a hard time forgiving myself.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
I did a lot of things in my life, man, that caused a lot of people a lot of pain.
Yeah.
And I couldn't come to that, you know, that realization that I need to forgive myself. May of last year, man, I was in my living room, man, of all places, and the Lord said to me, Eddie, I can't hear your prayers, man.
Oh.
I'm like, what do you mean by that, Lord? He said, read my word. He says, if you have aught against somebody, amen.
Come on.
Go to my altar, amen.
Yeah.
That's right.
And leave it there.
Help us, Lord.
That's right.
He said, Eddie, you're still carrying around yourself.
Come on.
He said, your prayers are being hindered in me.
Yeah.
So I forgave myself last year, man. Of all the things I ever done to people, amen, I forgave myself. In Christ. So,
well, glory.
Well, thank you. Thank you for putting up with me for the last hour and a half, or whatever it was. I want you to really seriously think about when the song's playing, man. You've done some things, amen, and I'm going to tell you something, man. You've not dealt with that. And you just need to give it to God, man. And stop looking at it. Stop washing it, amen.
Come on.
Stop romancing it, amen.
Amen.
And say, God, you know what? I gave it to you. And the enemy, man, the Bible says, man, he comes and brings condemnation, man, to those. Amen. But there's no condemnation in Christ.
Amen. Preacher, bro.
Why am I holding it in me?
Come on. Mm-hmm.
Come on.
The song's called, I've Forgiven Me. Amen.
Feels like
Bless you, Jesus.
It would make you mad. I don't care about making it. I can take it. You want me to?
Love you, Slinky. Love you, McRib.
Now I'll get a phone call on the way home. You have so much trouble.
Grandma, time to rock.
And I'll say, come get me. Georgia,
you won.
Way.
Well, amen. Hope you enjoy the new CD, amen. Remember, it's at my table today for $10. If you don't like it, give it to somebody you don't like. I got a message for you called Proclaim, Announce Publicly, amen. John 4:28 begins to tell the story or the pattern for the example of our life, what to do after we get saved. I can show you the scriptures, amen, where other people, man, they didn't even know each other, yet they did the same exact thing. John 4:28 says, then the woman left her water jar and went back into town, and she began telling people, amen, come and see a man who told me everything I ever did. Is this not the Messiah, the Christ? Can this be? I started to think about that water. She left her water pot at the well. Oh, y'all didn't follow that, did you? Let's read it one more time, amen. Just so we make sure that I'm not telling, you know, that's something that's not true. Then the woman left her water jar and went back. What did she leave? She left her, come on, I need some help out here now. Y'all can say water jar. She left her water jar. Watch this. Hey, there's some things in your life you're going to have to leave in order to tell somebody about Jesus. You have to leave it, amen. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I like this, man. Romans chapter 10, verse 14 says, how then will they call on him who they not believe? And how will they believe in him who they not heard? And how will they tell without a preacher? You see, you mentioned the word preacher now, amen? And people automatically assume, amen, Sunday morning at the pulpit. I got news for you. That is the furthest from the truth in that scripture in that context right there. I looked the word up preacher in the Greek. The word preacher means to proclaim. I looked at the word proclaim, and the word proclaim means announce